Trottier. Mario Lemieux, Ron Francis, Ulf Samuelsson, and Larry Murphy defies them off of the pins, plus Barrasso, Brett Sutter, Graham, Goulet, Roenick, Larmer, and Chelios. Chelios planted to the left point. The faceoff will be in the left wing circle, and Trottier turns around as the linesman, Scampanello, trying to get people settled in. They drop the puck. Who's going to get it? Murphy throw it in behind his own net. Ulf Samuelsson's after it. Empty net down to our right. Played up off the boards, but not out. Steve Larmer. Wayne it up and Ling, and it carries back to the Chicago zone. 28 seconds left. Chelios pulls back. He'll get it to Roenick. No, went right by. Trottier has it, trying to go to the empty net, and he can't do it. 22 seconds left here in regulation. Chelios steps up. He'll pass to Brent Sutter. Penguins lead 6-5. Roenick with the puck into the Penguins' end. Dance around one man. Shoots it, but he missed the net. 13 seconds left. Trottier golf it up. Lemieux's got the puck, and he can't get it out. Right in front of Flexen. Oh, what a save by Barrasso. Right up the play, and Goulet right in front. 5 seconds to go. Loose around to the far corner. 2 seconds. The Penguins are going to win the Stanley Cup, I believe. Stelio shoots it blocked. The Penguins have won the Stanley Cup. Oh, Lord Stanley. Lord Stanley, get me the brandy. The Pittsburgh Penguins have won the Stanley Cup. Mike Keenan shaking hands with Scotty Bowman. But the Penguins mob Tom Barrasso as they hold on. I'm telling you, it was that close to being a tie game. Goulet almost tied it for the Chicago Blackhawks as the Penguins celebrate behind the Penguin goal. Look at Tommy Barrasso, second straight year. Steve Lamb, the Pens equipment manager, hugging him. And Larry Murphy, a big squeeze in on Scotty Bowman. And I know somewhere, somebody looking down by the name of Badger Bob Johnson is watching this and enjoying it with all the emotion that he carried to the Penguins squad last year. Unbelievable feeling again for the Pittsburgh Penguins to win the Stanley Cup for the second consecutive year. And they do it by reeling off 11 straight wins in the playoffs, tying a record set by Chicago this year. And the Stanley Cup has been ushered out onto the ice. They will have the traditional handshake in just a moment. The Penguins winning the first two games at home and then winning the Stanley Cup on the road for the second consecutive year. Trottier shaking hands with Brett Sutter, Lemieux, and Barrasso around one another. We've got the handshake going on right now. We're missing a lot of that. This has been a hard-fought series. The Chicago Blackhawks had won 11 straight games prior to the series. And now they've lost 4 straight to the Pittsburgh Penguins. And they have beat a very tough hockey club, the Chicago Blackhawks. Goulet and Lemieux. And again, we still have the Conn Smythe Trophy for the most valuable player of this playoff series, or playoff year, I should add. And what a thrill it's got to be for a couple of guys that joined this club. For Rick Tocchet, Shel Samuelsson, and Kenny Reagan, who played only 20 minutes of the playoffs. And what a thrill it is for them to be able to capture the Stanley Cup for their first time ever. Joey Mullen of the Pens is on the ice. The Pens that did not play tonight in civvies will shake hands with the Blackhawks. Bob Erie and Rod Buskus now having words. There's so much going on, and it's tough to get it all to you, but just watching certain conversations, the Chicago fans giving their team, the Blackhawks, a big round of applause here, and rightly so, too. The guy that'll act like the young kid that he is in heart and everything is Brian Trottier. This is his 6th Stanley Cup, Brian Trottier. There's Jeremy Roenick, who finally got up on the board for the Hawks in the series, scoring twice. But tonight of the year, I belong to the Pittsburgh Penguins. Jeremy Roenick waves his hands to the fans, thanking them. Chris Chelios also for a big year of support. The Chicago team is an excellent hockey club. And the Penguins beat a strong team in Chicago. Rick Tocchet and Ronnie Francis, you can't see it, just high-fived one another with both hands and putting their arms around one another. Francis with his second experience, and now the Stanley Cup will be brought out.
And to receive the Stanley Cup for 1992 from NHL President John Ziegler on behalf of his teammates, Penguin captain Mario Lemieux.
So Mario Lemieux will come over and take the Stanley Cup. John Ziegler, the president of the National Hockey League, shaking his hand now. We're having the presentation of the cup at this moment. Lemieux calling for his teammates to come over. Here we go.
Of the Penguins. I wonder, Bob, whether this is the last time Mr. Ziegler will have the honor of doing this, with all kinds of consternation about his employment.
Well, we're picking up the feed of the Hockey Night in Canada right now, so our apologies to you. But here are the Penguins now surrounding that Stanley Cup. They'll go for a skate here at the stadium in Chicago. They've got more wires out there than you could imagine. This is absolutely a great thrill. It really is, no matter if it happens once, twice, three, four, five times. Look at Scotty Bowman with a big smile, giving a great big hug to Rick Tocchet right now. And there goes Lemieux, carrying the Stanley Cup around. It'll come back to Pittsburgh. And we will have a big day somewhere to celebrate this moment, believe me. And everybody in Western Pennsylvania, and if you're a Penguin fan from wherever you are invited to come down and be a part of the celebration. Rick Tocchet holds it high. Bob Airy, who did not play in game three. They're jumping over the television wires now as they come around. Shel Samuelson holds it for the first time ever in his career at 6'6", and nobody going to get it from him reaching up. Troy Loney has it. Now the Penguins showing an awful lot of character in this playoff year. And even in this game tonight, winning it once again in the third period against Chicago. Phil Bork. Well, the Pens have a little bit of history. Not only have they won the cup once, but twice, and a lot of these players were with the team last year. And Larry Murphy has that cup over his head. And Big Artie lets out that roar that only he can do as he holds it. And there is Jaromir Jagr. 2 years in the National Hockey League, two-time champion, 20 years of age. Where's McEachran at? Has he held it up yet? The rookie for the Penguins. What a thrill it's got to be for him. He played for the U.S. Olympic team. Paul Stanton. He's been in 2 years of the National Hockey League. Two Stanley Cups for Paul Stanton. They referred to him today in the Chicago papers as Bob Stanton. Once this year as Frank Stanton on an AP report. Well, it's Paul Stanton. He'll go on the Stanley Cup again. And Brian Trottier, for the sixth time in his career, holds that cup up high. There's Big Mac, first time ever, and hoping he got on board. Tom Barrasso. Stunning would be the word, I think, for his performance in the playoffs this year. And Yuri Herdina, who has won his third cup, one with Calgary, two with the Pens. Jimmy Pack, a rookie this year by rights in the National Hockey League, but played last year in the playoffs. He's on the Stanley Cup twice now. And Jock Callender, what a story that is. Jock Callender and Dave Mikhailuk will both be on the Stanley Cup. They came from Muskegon, and the Lumberjacks were in the finals. They joined the Penguins with injuries to the Penguins squad. And Skip Thayer, who for 18 years was a trainer here in Chicago, holds it above his head. Rick Patterson, a player for the Hawks, and now a coach for the Penguins, grabs possession of it. But Jock Callender, Dave Mikhailuk coming up to join the Penguins and contributing, too, in a special way to help them win this cup. And I'll tell you, you don't do it with 20 guys to win a Stanley Cup. You need a lot of players to make it happen, and the Penguins had that this year. They'll combine themselves now together and take another group picture as they did last year, which was so famous. Here's Mikhailuk, who did not play tonight, but an integral part of it. Mike Needham also out there. The redhead holds it above his head for the first time. These are guys that were in Muskegon and had no idea that they would get an opportunity to play for the Stanley Cup this year. And they did. Frank Schuele holds it up high. Just recently lost his wife on a big moment for him. A.T., who's been in the Penguin locker room along with Frankie for many, many years. They're very much a part of the Penguin scene. Big red Tracy there. Does he get a chance to hold it up? Kittleberger, John Welday, the Pens conditioning coach. And in mass, they will hold it. Wendell Young's in there somewhere with a hat on. And there is Lord Stanley's Cup. Picked up again by Mario Lemieux. Lemieux will skate off. The Penguins have done it for the second year in a row. And they win it on the road. They don't care where they won it as long as they've captured the biggest prize in hockey, the Stanley Cup. Well, now they've turned them around the other way. They were headed off to the Penguin locker room, but I think what they want to do is take a picture at center ice here, as they did last year in Minnesota, and have everybody gather around and be a part of history. And this is a very special moment for these guys. Believe me, this will be one that you will see. You got to make sure everybody gets in there, and that's important. Brian Trottier, Mario Lemieux. Boys will be boys, and they're going to have some fun. Everybody being a part of it all, winning the Stanley Cup. And now the photographers just freewheel as they take picture after picture after picture, and one that they take, one of the pictures of the hundreds that they are taking right now, will come out as a poster. And you will see it. The 92 Stanley Cup champions, the Pittsburgh Penguins, led by Scotty Bowman, who coached them this year. And they are repeat winners. What a thrill it's got to be. Scotty Bowman, I was going to tell the story in the third period, has gone to the finals 8 times in his career. The first 3 times he lost in the finals. He has now won 6 straight, 5 with the Montreal Canadiens, and now 1 with the Pittsburgh Penguins. We'll be back here in Chicago in just a moment. The final score tonight, the Penguins 6 and the Hawks 5, the Penguins.